Please remain standing in silence, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's do this.
Here we go.
Jess, I have a question. Did the quesadilla come back with you?
Absolutely not. So I got extra time. Sorry, you gotta get this. Oh. I got a big mic coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for our co-main event of the evening. It takes place in the 154 pound division under full contact kickboxing rules inside of 12 two-minute rounds. It is for the WKL Pro Light Middleweight World Championship. Keith Peterson is the referee in charge of the action. Introducing first the challenger approaching the blue corner, ladies and gentlemen, Jason Mosello.
Hey, that's a good look right there.
Good marketing.
That's your profile picture right there. Full contact, they wear these little booties.
Wait, so is he going to fight in pants? I feel claustrophobic for him right now.
Yeah, they wear pants because they wear those like booties and stuff.
I feel claustrophobic. I would definitely rip a seam on the butt.
There's definitely no lack of humor when it comes to YouTube, lady.
I'm sure there's people watching this that are like shocked.
If people read Panther's text messages, they probably would commit us both to like
the same word. Like, put your hands behind your back.
Yeah, it's not normal.
Whoa, he's got some hands, this guy.
Could you fight in pants like that?
No.
I would rip them at the butt seat.
Next time you wear sweatpants,
I can't
take the top off and then just throw some hands. That's like what he's doing right now.
I don't know.
It's interesting that there's a gladiator skirt over it.
I've literally never seen someone fighting pants in any sport in my life.
Are you not entertained?
I'm entertained. There's no lack of entertainment.
I know it's not about me, but
but I gotta make it about me
somehow.
That video,
somewhat.
That video of me doing the ring card drill, send it to me.
I love this. Bobby has all his titles.
My life.
Look at all the kids. I love it.
And his son's the best, the little guy.
That's cute.
All the
like
kids walking him out.
Jesus, how many belts is this?
Well, I believe Bobby's over, I think he's like an 11-time champion.
I love this.
That's so many belts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
That's Bobby's son, the little guy.
10. Oh my God, my heart.
I can't.
He's very cute.
Nothing weighs more than him, man.
Oh, that's adorable. That's so cute.
I'm really trying not to sing along.
I'm going to cry.
There's a microphone on it.
Look at his little cross.
They're not in sport mode, though.
Jax taught me about sport mode. I'm like, what are you talking about sport mode?
This is exciting.
And Bobby Campbell's huge over in Europe.
Yeah.
They know Bobby. He's been over there numerous times fighting. He's very well known over in England.
That's awesome.
So who corners Bobby? Does his brother corner him?
I think his brother's cornering him. You see Tom right there and someone else. I think Sinatra might be with him.
Long Beach.
My boy Sinatra.
Yeah, boy.
My boy.
Oh, here he is.
Nice. Oh, I'm like hyped up for this right now.
Me too. The final curtain.
The final curtain. Here it is, right here.
Let's go, Bobby. I kind of want to fight in pants.
I can never.
After this is over, we'll get you girls in there. Well, you'll wear your sweatpants and go to town.
We'll try it next time. Let's spar in jeans.
I'm just,
fighting in a denim jacket.
Yeah, I like that. A little Canadian tuxedo.
What's that all about?
These people people do it all. They fight, they corner all in one night. It's like crazy to me. Like,
I mean, not to make it about me, but like I commentate and a ring card girl is insane.
That's true. I've never done that. I've never commentated and been a ring card boy.
You know what? Same.
You should do that next time.
Yeah,
you gotta get you in the ring.
Yes. We gotta get in the ring.
Yeah, that would have been way better.
In the middle, you'll start shadow boxing. I'll rip my shirt off like the Hulk. Should be good.
That would literally be the best. Oh yeah, like a collab.
The viewership might go down real quick.
No, it'll go up.
A collab.
Yes. Well, I'm excited and nervous.
This contest is for the WKL Light Middleweight World Championship.
That's crazy. Right here at Mulcahy's World Championship.
First, the challenger competing out of the blue corner, hailing from Blackmore, Essex, England, representing TW1, standing 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing at 151.6 pounds, entering this bout with a stellar record of 134.6.
Oh my God!
Ladies and gentlemen,
134.6. That's absurd.
Goals.
The crowd right now. This hypes me up.
I have anxiety.
Is
awesome
Rocky
fight.
His son's name? His son's name is Rocky, right?
Rocky.
Yeah, Rocky. That's why he has on his trunk. I love that. I'm going to do that.
So, taking
notes.
You see, I don't know if the shirt says Rocky.
I noticed that, but I was thinking like boxing Rocky, but I don't know his son's name is Rocky, and now it all makes
He's got a tattoo on the forearm as well. Here we go. Keith Peterson, third man in the ring. 12 rounds, 2 minutes apiece.
12 rounds.
Let's do it.
Oof, right with the
kick. Right off the bat, yeah. I mean, with 12 rounds, you got to pace yourself a little.
Over 130 fights, that's insane. Oof.
As I was saying to Kyle before, I think you were eating your quesadilla. If you have 130 fights, imagine how many rounds of sparring you have.
Yeah, that's insane.
I can't even imagine. How many years has
punches
he been fighting?
Punches,
I don't know how old he is.
Doesn't look that old.
I feel like they're probably around the same age.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, I would probably put that about the same, yeah. But it's like, what, do two fights in a night?
Yeah, exactly.
True.
Or he started when he was like 6.
Yeah, because that's his pro record, correct?
Yeah, that's his pro record.
Yeah, I'm like, when did he turn pro? At like
amateur, I think
18?
He had like 400. No, I'm just kidding, I don't know.
What? Are you just making that
up?
Yeah,
I just made that up.
He's like a Lomachenko.
But you don't see that anymore in boxing either anymore. Like, everyone used to have, like, these crazy records in boxing. Like
in amateurs, they still do. You meet amateurs with hundreds and hundreds of fights.
Yeah.
Pro, I think it's a little
Yeah, how many fights did you say you have, Jess?
I have 35 fights in 3 years. Yeah.
Which is insane.
Yeah.
Which isn't as much as, like, some of the guys.
Yeah, some of the guys. It's harder for girls.
Some of the guys, it's, like, 150. Yeah.
But, like, I know MMA fighters that are amateurs and have 6 in their whole career.
Yeah.
I fought 8 times in 5 weeks. That was like the most I did at once.
That's vicious. That's got to be brutal on your body.
Ooh, nice body work by Bobby.
Yeah, that was beautiful, actually.
It has been back and forth.
He went body head, body head, body head.
They're well matched. I know, what's his opponent?
Jason Vassallo.
He has a lot of fights, but this is a well matched fight, you know. So
he has
far,
a lot of
one.
Fainting, too. He moves his head even when he's not throwing.
So I think because of the booties, they could do like sweeps and stuff.
Oh wow,
they can?
Okay.
That's fun.
Bobby's got quick hands.
Jesus.
That's why they call him the jackhammer.
I mean, I know he's had straight boxing fights, right? So he definitely has.
Yeah, and I've seen him. I remember Yeah, one time I saw him on mitts at Law MMA, and I remember being like shocked at his boxing.
That's like, what do you guys score that round? I feel like that's a hard round to score.
I have no idea. I actually have no idea.
It's a very hard, tough one.
Yeah.
To be honest, I think if we had a scorekeeper that I was clicking, I think Bobby probably landed more strikes in that round.
I'm going to go with a draw because I really don't know.
That's a tough first round.
Which is a good sign. It's a good fight. You know?
Yeah, I agree.
Now we just need 11 more rounds like that.
Yes.
And then, yeah, just throw it up in the air and whoever
just
wins it.
A draw and then they need to do a rematch. I'm just saying.
Bobby's never retiring. Yeah. We're here forever, Bobby.
The final curtain.
You know this dude didn't fly over from England to
lose.
You know what I mean?
Right, of course.
And now I wonder how early he arrived because that time difference.
He was here a few days ago.
Still, you got to adjust.
I wonder how he's feeling.
I think he got here Wednesday or Thursday.
He's got to be exhausted. I went to Costa Rica.
He took a canoe, though, so he didn't...
Yeah. It was 2 hours.
It was 1 million miles.
Exhausted. Yeah, 1 million miles.
He was like 200 pounds when he started. When he got here, it was 150.
Bobby's like focused. You could see it in his face, you know?
Bobby just got caught a little too tight on that spinning kick.
Well, that's like the move. Someone throws a spinning. You see them spin, you just run in before they get it.
Yeah, Weidman unfortunately knows all about that.
Nice. Bobby is controlling the ring so far this fight. He's, you know, pressuring.
He's doing a lot of boxing, actually.
Yeah.
You know where
that's what I was
all
saying.
About
he
the dark side. Ooh, that body shot.
Right.
You can tell Bobby has boxing experience for sure.
Yeah.
Oof. Great
he's
fight
strong
so
with
far.
Bad intentions, too. He's not just, you know.
Yeah, that body shot was awesome. Double jab. We love that.
I don't know how well that landed.
I don't know. It looks like he blocked it, but I'm sure you still feel it.
Good setup. Jason has some good head work, too.
Yeah.
He throws, he ducks, he faints.
I thought he's going to do it Diaz.
Beautiful counter to that kick. That was
to choke Jake Paul.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
Nice sweep right there.
That was nice.
You see me like throws the sweep as he coming in with a punch as well. I've never really seen this style a whole lot. Used to see it a little bit on Versus back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
But Bobby's the only person I see it.
That was so nice by Bobby. Ducked under that,
Knew
the angle, and then put it on the rope.
Yes.
I love what he just did.
Yes.
Big shots right there.
Yes.
But again, smothering himself on the ropes, take a half step back and.
Woo! Yeah, I feel you because they're getting a little close, so some of them are at the back of the head.
And it happens. When you're on the ropes, you
nice
want to just go crazy. But
for sure. You get excited.
Yeah.
I mean, it's his last fight.
Absolutely.
He's pumped.
Yeah,
that round I give Bobby.
I do, too. Same. I think it's a draw and a Bobby.
All right, so we'll call it 1-0 right now.
I'm
going
to lose
two.
Count.
Just to play devil's advocate, I'm going to say 1-1.
All right, we'll play 1-1. Let's do it. I'm not putting any quesadillas on the line, though.
Yeah, me either.
Well, I think you guys took care of that.
We don't have any left.
I'll bet you my lettuce, Sarah.
I'll give you three clips of lettuce. How about those beans?
And a bowl of beans.
And a bowl of beans.
Some sour.
I'll take the guac.
Yeah.
the guac and the cream cheese?
Cream cheese.
Oh, wait, what is that?
Sour cream. Definitely.
I forgot the name, too. Weird. I had a blank.
Cream cheese sounded right.
I love it. All right, so 1-1, we're calling it.
Oh, I guess the coach is going to stay in
there. I'm calling it.
You're calling a draw one. But
a draw one, yeah.
I'm with you, but.
I'm going to try to keep track, but it gets hard when you get pumped up.
You got to watch the ring car girls, you know? You'll know what round it is if they do their job better than you.
They do.
Keith Peterson here, the referee. We see him all over the UFC doing big-time fights. He's also a kid wrestling
coach. Oh, that's how
coach.
I recognize him. He's always on the UFC.
Yep.
He's
from Long Island. He's actually from Islip.
Oh, really?
He lives in Islip, and he coaches kids, his daughter's on the wrestling team. So girls wrestling team.
How old is she?
I don't know.
We're talking like elementary school or like?
Yeah, like elementary, middle school.
Okay. Oh, that's awesome. I love seeing more girls in combat sports.
Talking to him before we started, he said there's about 25 girls on the team.
That's amazing.
That is awesome.
We should go hang out with them.
Yeah, I would be so down. Girls in combat sports, make me so happy.
Women's wrestling is just exploding.
Yeah,
right now,
I love it.
Which is, it is awesome.
And it's a great opportunity
nice
to get a
Bobby.
Scholarship, too.
Bobby's yeah, definitely controlling this, but he smothers himself when he gets on the ropes. He's controlling the pace, he's controlling the ring, but he gets good position.
Oh, that double jab. I can't lie. Jason's double jab's nice.
Yeah. Oh, good splash of sweat on the face. Nothing like it.
There you go.
What I noticed
nice
about...
Nice left by Jason.
See, right here, if Bobby would just take a half step back, I feel like he'd have a lot more success.
Yeah, Bobby ate a left.
He gets on the ropes. He's
so, watch Jason's double jab. It's like both punches are with bad intention.
Yeah.
It's not like a...
They're like
he's not a feeling
jabs,
out jab. Yeah. It's a hard jab.
Let me tell you, for a guy who has been out of fighting for a while, Bobby, he looks pretty good.
Oh, you can tell Bobby has just talent. You know, he works hard. He's talented. He's... You can see it in his face. He has, like, focus.
I feel like they both switched stances, right?
Yeah, they've been moving.
I feel like Bobby came out lefty and Jason came out righty, and then they switched.
You know when these guys have the amount of fights that they have,
they're
the amount of times they probably switch stance inside that ring is probably double it.
I give that round to Bobby, too.
I do, too, actually.
I think they're both exchanging these controls.
That was definitely a better round, though, for Jason.
I have a draw, too.
Me, too.
You have a draw for that round?
No, for the
first round.
Oh, all right.
Next two rounds, Bobby.
Just for devil's advocate, I'm going one for Jason, two for Bobby.
Okay.
Because I'm not really a big believer. You know how everyone always says if you're the champion, you have to beat the champion?
Oh, I don't.
I don't really think that's like a real thing. Like,
I don't either.
Like, just because, like, he might not have done as much as you expected. He wins? I don't know.
I agree, yeah.
Like, I'm not a big fan of that phrase.
I also don't like that you have to fight, like, five times to prove that you're the champion.
Champion, yeah.
Like, you need, like, five rematches. Like,
yeah, you won.
Like, yeah.
How many times do you have to prove it?
Right, next. All right, here we go. Round four.
Unless it was, like, super close, then that's one thing, but...
Yeah, for the fans,
like,
but people need to respect the decision. I like Jason's jab, I'm telling you.
Bobby hasn't really utilized the jab a whole lot in this fight.
He's doing more of like a range, like paw jab.
As you can see, Bobby is a lefty. Oh,
no.
No.
Fuck. What a
shot.
Wow.
No way. Was that a jab or a right hand?
I think that was
that was a hook, I thought.
Yeah, I think it was a left hook that caught him. Fuck. Wow, what a shot by Jason.
That was a good punch.
That's all it takes is one, man.
Yeah, Bobby's out of it.
I would say Bobby was winning that fight.
That was a good call, though.
All it takes is one, yeah.
Yeah, because he wasn't getting up.
Damn.
And if he did, it just wouldn't have been a good idea.
That's a tough way to go out.
Tough way, yeah.
He's still a warrior, though.
He was fighting beautifully. He was winning the fight, you know. It was one punch. And
that's why fighting is so crazy.
You never know.
And we had him winning on the scorecards, actually.
Absolutely.
Wow, what a shot.
That's why fighting is the most interesting.
You can't predict it.
Yeah.
Entertaining sport. Things happen no matter what.
And Jason improves to 135.
I wish I could see a
Jason improves to 1 million and a million.
Yeah, 1 million fights.
Wow, what a shot. What a finish. Yeah,
that
Bobby, that was a great call by Peterson.
Yeah,
I agree. That was good.
He was talking to Bobby, and then Bobby came back, and you can see Bobby goes, what happened?
Yeah.
And Bobby's already proved himself. He doesn't.
Right.
No, there's nothing to prove.
He has a kid. He was a multi-champion.
And even talk
so.
About, like we were saying, how many fights they have, how many sparring rounds, how many times they've gotten hit in the head. At some point, you don't need to get hit in the head anymore.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
We've seen too many injuries and too many, you know.
Agreed.
Wow.
But damn.
He gets to live, fight another day.
Fight another day. And he's got his son, Rocky. And
Rocky can fulfill his
era.
Legacy.
New era.
And his brother.
Yeah.
He's still a champion in my book.
Absolutely.
Jason Vassallo comes over here.
I lost count of the belts, actually. I tried to count. I think I saw 10,
but I lost count.
He's at least a 10-time world champion, Bobby.
Yeah. And that just shows 10-time world champion takes one punch. This sport is different.
Yep.
This sport is different. Remember Conor McGregor with the one punch?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's all it takes is one shot. Dropped Aldo with that.
Yeah. Was it the first punch? It was close to the first punch.
It was the first punch. It was like the second, yeah.
Yeah.
But he got clipped, too, when he threw it.
Yeah. And it just happens.
Placement.
I mean, you can't play boxing. You can't play kickboxing.
That's true. You play badminton, though.
Anyone can have that punch. Yeah, you can play badminton. That's why when people are like, what would you do in a street fight? I'm like, run away.
Yeah.
Like, anyone can knock you out.
I'm like, do we get weapons?
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Is this like the Purge?
Leave.
Yeah, pistol whip someone and run. That's why it blows my mind when people go to sporting events and in the stands they're fighting.
Oh, my God.
I'm like, what are you getting out of that? Let me tell you, at the end of the day, a lot of times, like obviously combat sports is different because it's all on you, but, like, professional athletes in the football, baseball, hockey, they don't care if they, like, they do care, but it's not the same. They're still getting paid at the end of the day.
Absolutely. It's so different.
It's less on your ego, too.
Yeah.
You're in there alone.
Right. A team sport alone versus, not that you're not on a team here, but when you're in the ring, everything is on you. You know, it's not. It's different if a team messes up and you lose as a team. It's not.
It's an individual sport with a team attached.
They call boxing the loneliest sport in the world, you know?
Yeah.
You know what I will say, though? I was on a streak where I was winning, and when I lost finally, I was relieved.
Yeah?
Why?
Yeah, because I felt like I had to win all the time.
Yeah.
And then when I finally lost, I was like, okay.
So worried about keeping that the egg at the end.
Yeah. And then I was like, okay, this is fine. Now I can eat.
Yeah.
Like, it actually felt good to lose. Because I always had so much anxiety.
So, is...
Not losses,
is
lessons.
Jason retiring, too, or...
I don't know. I'm not really sure where his...
Or is he's going to be part of our geriatric boxing.
He might be.
Oh, we could recruit him.
Okay. Just checking.
We'll put him on the list.
Ladies and gentlemen, in 1 minute and 20 seconds on the fourth round, the winner of this contest by way of knockout... And the new WKL Light Middleweight Champion, Jason Vassallo!
Aw.
Jason even looks like he's upset.
Jason is a sweetheart. We love this. We love sportsmanship. We love this. They're good guys. You can tell.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, you got all the English crew over here.
Respect.
Is they just tackling the ropes right there?
It was good. I wanted more, though.
I wonder how the fight would have been if it weren't for a knockout punch.
Yeah, I'm
not
curious.
If it went the distance.
Maybe they'll do a rematch. The final curtain.
I agree with you.
The final curtain squared.
Since Sarah, you know, coined that term, we have to commentate for it.
Yeah. The one millionth final curtain. And I'll be like ring car girl.
For the final curtain squared.
That's a good pick.
That's cute.
And there you have it. You get the whole crew in there. I think that's the whole country.
I don't even think I could
all
get that
many. All 1 million of them.
I couldn't get that many people to come to my
fight. Me neither. I don't even know that many people.
I don't have that many friends.
And they flew over here.
Yeah, jeez. Talk about having a lot of friends.
I know. I'd be lucky to get my parents to show up.
Literally.
They're like, nah, yeah, you're too old for this.
But it's kind of fun. It's like if you were like, I'm fighting in England, I'd be like, all right, how can I figure out how to get over there?
Paris 2024, man.
Yeah. Oh, I'm there. Wee.
Aw, that's sweet.
And we have another fight still.
We have one more fight.
Co-main event coming up.
And this is it? It's over already?
I know. Isn't that fast? This girl has some good calves, too, when she was jumping.
She does have good calves.
I'm on calves.
Sarah, after these fights, can you rate my calves once
again? I have to look at them while you're...
I have, just so you know,
mine are like a 1. And you're built like me, so you might be like a 1.
1.5.
Because we're like very not calf.
No, we're not calf.
Yeah.
There you have it. Jason Vassallo, the new champion. WKL Professional Light Middleweight World Champion.
I will say his punches, I noticed he's throwing them all hard.
Yeah, you loved his jab, you did.
Yeah, I did love his jab.
Big fan.
Ladies
probably helps.
Gentlemen, it is now time for our main event of the evening.
I will not. I can stop. I can't.
It takes place on the
Next to girls are crazy.
160-pound division kickboxing championship. Our first competitor approaching the blue corner at this time. Here is Inea Abdia.
Yes, almighty.